Hello everyone, I'm Ryan with PC Part Picker, and welcome back to another build video. Today we're putting together a high-end Kaby Lake gaming machine based on the Intel Core i7-7700K and SLI GTX 1080s. A big thanks to ASRock for providing the Z270 supercarrier and NZXT for the Kraken X52 CPU cooler. Check the description below for a link to the full part list. Let's get started. Our motherboard for this build is ASRock's new flagship model, the Z270 supercarrier. Included in the box, we have our motherboard manual, driver disks, I/O shield, four SATA cables, one of which we'll use for our 3.5-inch drive, mounting screws for M.2 drives, and our Wi-Fi antennas. Additionally, we have four SLI bridges for a variety of graphics card configurations, since our motherboard does have four X16 slots and supports up to four-way SLI. Should you use four graphics cards, you will need to plug in the supplementary power down at the bottom corner of the board. Our processor for this build is the Intel Core i7-7700K. Open the latch on the CPU socket and lift it up. Then remove the processor from its plastic packaging. You'll notice on the corner of the CPU there's a golden triangle, and this is the pin 1 indicator, which should line up with the white triangle on the CPU socket. Set the processor gently into place. Then close the latch. We have 32 gigabytes of Team Dark DDR4 memory for our build. Open the latch on all four of the DIMM slots. Then take the memory, line it up with the DIMM slot, and push it in. It should click when secure. For our primary storage, we have the Samsung 960 EVO NVMe SSD. We've chosen to use the top Ultra M.2 slot to avoid putting our SSD underneath the graphics card for better airflow. Place the drive into the M.2 slot and secure it with the screw. Since we're using the unlocked Core i7-7700K, we've selected the Kraken X52 from NZXT to cool it. Included with the cooler, we have our manual, mounting hardware for both AMD and Intel, and two 120mm fans. We've positioned the mounting posts on our backplate in the innermost position for LGA 1151. Lift up the motherboard and place the backplate in the holes around the socket. Hold it in your hand and screw in the post from the other side. Before placing the motherboard in the case, remember to put in the I/O shield. Inside the Anodyze AI Crystal, the standoffs are already pre-installed. Using the case accessories that came with it, we've installed one extra standoff right here for our motherboard. Place the motherboard gently in the case, aligning it with the standoffs and the rear I/O. Secure the motherboard to the case using the provided standoff screws. To power our system, we've selected the EVGA Supernova G3 750-watt power supply. It's a fully modular unit, which means none of the cables are permanently attached, and it comes with a wide variety here for all sorts of different configurations. For our build, though, we only need to use these six cables. Plug in the cables, starting with the 24-pin. Eight-pin CPU power, SATA power, Molex, and our PCIe cables for our graphics cards. The bottom of our case has a dust filter and a grill for a fan, so we'll place our power supply with its fan pointed down to intake cold air and exhaust it out the back. Secure it to the case using the screws provided with the power supply. We've routed our cables through the cable management holes in the case. The Anity's AI Crystal comes with a vanity cover for these cables. Secure it with a thumb screw. Connect the front panel and power supply cables, starting with the HD audio. USB 2.0 cable. Hard drive LED. Reset switch. Power button. Power LED. SATA data cable for our hard drive. USB 3.0 cable. 24-pin power cable. And the 8-pin EPS cable. The Anity's AI Crystal comes included with four case fans. Three of them in the front for intake and one in the back for exhaust. So we place the fans on our X62 radiator to push through it and exhaust out the top. Secure the fans to the radiator using the long screws and washers that came with the Kraken. Remove the magnetic dust filter from the top of the case so that we can reach the mounting holes for the radiator. Place the radiator into the case and align it with the mounting holes. Secure the radiator to the case using the short screws and washers provided with the cooler. Connect the power and fan cable to the CPU block. Then connect the USB cable. Remove the plastic cover from the bottom of the CPU block. You'll notice that the thermal paste is already pre-applied. Place the CPU block on the processor, aligning it with the standoffs. Secure the CPU block to the processor using the provided thumb screws. Connect the CPU fan cable to the header on the motherboard. And connect the USB 2.0 cable to the 2.0 header on the motherboard. Connect the rear case fan to the fan header on the motherboard. Connect the radiator fans to the fan cable from the Kraken. Then connect the SATA power cable to the power supply. Our three intake fans are connected to the built-in fan controller, which is powered by Molex. Connect that to our power supply. To mount our hard drive, we have to move the 3.5-inch drive sled. Place the 3 TB Seagate drive on the drive sled, then flip it over and secure it with the screws included with the case. Place the 3.5-inch drive sled back in the drive cage. and secure it with the screw. Connect the SATA power cable to the hard drive. And connect the SATA data cable as well. Before we can install our graphics cards, we first need to remove the vanity plate covering the expansion slots. Remove the first, second, fifth, and sixth expansion slot covers. Open the latch on the X16 slots, then gently set each graphics card into place. Place the vanity plate back in the case and secure it. Then secure the graphics card using the screws we just removed. Connect one 8-pin PCIe power cable to each graphics card. The Supercarrier motherboard came with a flexible SLI bridge, as well as a 2-slot high bandwidth SLI bridge. Because we've spaced our graphics cards out a little bit further, we had to purchase a longer high bandwidth SLI bridge, which we got from Zotac to match the aesthetic of our build. Place the SLI bridge on the graphics cards and push it into place. Finally, peel the protective cover off of the infinity mirror on the Kraken CPU block. If you plan to use the built-in Wi-Fi functionality on the Supercarrier, remember to attach the antennas to the back of the motherboard. With all of our cables and components in place, flip the switch on the power supply and press the power button to give it a quick test boot before we manage the cables. And that's the screen we're looking for. All we have to do now is clean up the cables and install the operating system. Thanks for joining us for another successful build video. And a big thanks to ASRock for providing the motherboard and NZXT for providing the cooler for this build. Make sure to check out our cable management video and check the description below for a link to our completed build on PC Part Picker with benchmarks and additional pictures. If you enjoyed our content today or learned anything new, please give us a like and subscribe.